almost forgot my book. I'm just making sure I'm not sweating. Today's gonna be fun. We're talking about getting rid of negative people in our lives, and that means friends. But before we get into it, my name is Asia. If you don't know, hi, welcome to my channel. For you guys watching, welcome back. And oh yeah, so I learned this thing. There's a bell icon on my page, right? You click that bell and you get notified every time I post a new video. Okay, so we're just gonna dive right into this. Freaking cops.
3 hours later.
Negative friends, yes. I believe we all had them. Oh my gosh, I can't even do a freaking video. I think we're good. Anyways, negative friends, yes. And I wanna highlight envious too. I feel like we all had friends that were maybe secretly jealous of us, or they were just out in the open with it blatantly and just really didn't care.
Bruh.
Which to me is very weird. Are you that positive friend? You're always trying to be happy. You're always trying to see the positive stuff. And your friend is just always the negative one. Just, and I don't want to say friend. We might have friends that are like that. And you just feel like you want to, not a new circle. Like you just want, like you're trying to change for the better. So you want to have that energy around you as well. So you don't want anyone that's always seeing the negative or always trying to bring you down. Like misery really... misery really loves company, and it took me a while to see that. I didn't know how to handle it at first. At first, it was like, you know, right? Yeah, this does suck. I don't like this either. You're right. Yeah, that isn't cute, huh? And then after a while, it gets boring. Like, yo, you don't like nothing. That's where I felt like I had to try to be the good person, because obviously if you're always feeling like that, there's something going on within you, because you're projecting that on everything else. And that's when you try to be the good friend and try to talk to them, cheer them up. I had to get rid of a lot of people in my life, and I feel like we shouldn't be scared to make that sacrifice. You have every right to protect your happy bubble. You have every right to protect your happiness and your peace. If you feel someone is trying to invade that and let their negative energy come off on you, that's not fair to you. Like, why do you deserve that? To be honest, they don't even deserve that. That's something that they should be fighting. And if you want to be that good friend to help them fight, go right ahead. I'm being selfish. I can't do it. Like, you could try to a minimum, but after a while it gets tiring. Like, nah, I'm okay. I really need to handle some things for myself. It's okay for you to handle some things for yourself. So it can be selfish. It's fine to be selfish. But the envious ones, those are the scary ones that always, you know, they always saying some slick stuff under their breath, or they joke a little bit too much about you. Like, making fun of you in a way, like, you got a big nose. I'm just playing. Your eyebrows bushy, yo. They ugly. Nah, I'm just playing. You think you cute in that outfit? You think you cute in that outfit? Psst. That shit is real. Pay attention to that. That's just not, like, playing around. You gotta really... If you know that person and you feel funny vibes from them and they're always like that, trust your instinct. God did not give us that. He wouldn't give us that gift to be able to read vibes. I'm a big strong believer in that. Yeah, I had people in my life that I had to give up on, and it totally sucks to do that, but you have to let that go. This is you. You could be the good person. Oh, look at that. That's so sweet. That's so beautiful. Isn't that cute, girl? That is so nice, huh? And then this is your negative friend.
What you mean? That was ugly. Why are you trying to gas her up like that? That's not even cool. You need to stop it. That shit's not even cute. I don't even know why you're doing that. I don't even see why you're saying that she looks cute. She doesn't look cute. I know you don't think she looks cute. I know she looks cute. I don't even know why you're saying that. Look at her hair. Look at her shoes. Her outfit is real. Stop hanging around. You just trying to be a friend. I don't even know why you're trying to be a friend.
Hanging around people that always want to see the bad and stuff. Stop. Because then that's going to... Misery loves company. So they're attaching to you because they want someone to feel that negativity along with them. And it's like, why do you want to feel like that? Why do you want to be unhappy? I don't know. Same for guys too. Guys, y'all can have guy friends and you just always noticing your boy always saying some slick mess under his mouth. You really try not to like pay attention to it. Don't let the negative envious friends, and it sucks because they can be someone that you've been friends with for a very long time, and it sucks that the friendship has to go away like that. But that's like, you're not one to question how it is. Like, I knew someone that, like, you know, they would say slick shit under their breath, but I never really paid attention to it. I just took it as jokes.
Really, nigga?
And then I noticed that the jokes started becoming, like, you know, under their breath type jokes. Like, it wouldn't even be something that I could hear. It'll be crazy, because I don't know if anyone else does this, but when you smoke, you can hear, like, everything gets intensified. And I just remember hearing them say some, like, I remember what they said, but I'm not gonna, like, I don't know if I should just say it, because then whatever, I'm not gonna say it. They said something funny under their breath, and I was just like, word, like, that's how you feel. That one funny moment, and me in response to how I acted to it, it went from that funny mumble to short text messages, not texting each other a lot, to just not doing it at all, not even talking. And it's like, God purposely detaches people for you. Like, he shows you something, and then it's up to you whether you take that sign or not. Like, you could either just really ignore the big red X in front of your face if you want to, or you can see the sign and be like, thank you for showing me that. I'm sorry that didn't work out as a friendship, but that's how God made it, and I'm not one to complain. Because you do notice when you do get rid of them, everything's so much easier. You can breathe, you can think for yourself, you can finally think clear, your happy thoughts can remain happy, you can line yourself up with other people that have that same energy. Because there's nothing worse than having someone that's super close to you that's super negative, and especially when you're at a critical sensitive time in your life, like in your 20s, your early 20s, late 20s, you're trying to find yourself, trying to either explore new things, you're trying to find out who you are, so you're going on new adventures, you're trying to step out of your comfort zone. And if you're stuck with someone that's not really trying to do that, they can hold you back. Tell yourself, you know what, it's okay that I'm changing. Like, I'm supposed to grow. That looks so nasty. I'm supposed to grow. It's okay that you're growing. That's what's supposed to happen, you know. And if you're stuck with someone, and then when you start to change, when you start to become a butterfly, you notice some people, they're not really feeling you no more. They'll love you no more. Stick with people that have the same goals as you, or hang out with people that have already reached their goals so you can learn from them. And it's okay if you're doing stuff and, you know, you're making new friends. It's okay to explore. I'll tell one thing for sure. I always said this, God did not make this big ass planet for you to stay in one state, for you to know only a certain amount of people. Go around the world, change lives. I don't have the money to do that, but when I do, best believe I'm going to different places. I'm exploring, I'm seeing what was given to me that I didn't have the right to see because I was being held back by money, and that's okay. And to have friends that have that same goal with you, you guys will build up together and make dreams come true together, and that's what it is. And if you have that negative, envious friend, they're not gonna pick up on your vibe. And you gotta be okay with, that's what I mentioned. If you have me on Facebook, I don't know if you remember a status I put, you have to be okay with losing friends and family to like do what you have to do for yourself and your future. But don't let that thought scare you. A lot of people get scared because they're like, oh, I have to. No. Don't be scared, because that's where you are going to step out of your comfort zone and see that it's not as bad as your fear portrayed it to be. It's actually something that you needed. And then when you do it, you feel better. You're like, oh, you know, I can do anything now. I'm not saying get rid of your negative friend now. I'm saying do it yesterday. Cuz, bro, why do you want to be with people that just want to see you stuck down. Feel me? I don't know if you guys remember Say the Last Dance. I don't even remember the character's name. In the end, when he wanted to go, I think he wanted to go to school with the girl, and his boy wanted him to like do some shit, like some shooting shit, I guess some revenge shit, and he didn't want to do it. He chose like the high road. He possibly lost him as a friend, but that's the type of sacrifice you have to make for yourself. That's when you really tell yourself that you love yourself and you want to surround yourself with positive energy. Always feel it in your gut when someone doesn't like you. Like, you can go by vibes, and if your friend gives you that vibe, listen to it. You get to get out your comfort zone because you're so comfortable with that person, but it's like, do you not notice that they're holding you back? I'm not even trying to say persons, if it's people, which is even harder, but who cares? You run you control you deserve to be happy, and you deserve to kick out any negative, envious person. You know what's strange? I know it's totally off topic. There's this girl that I used to be friends with in elementary, and she used to like pick on me and bully me every day, right? Literally pick on me and bully me every day. And she, right after school, like right after doing that, right after school, she'd call my house phone to talk to me. Like, we were like best friends. And I'm like, why am I even associating with you? Bullying's a whole nother video. That's a whole nother video. I don't want to keep saying get yourself a new clique. Be your own new clique. Be your own best friend. You have that vision for yourself. Have a vision for yourself. Don't let nobody that fears success make you fear your success. If you're a good person, you don't want to let the person go because you see the good in them. Even if they are envious and jealous, maybe, you know, you can try to talk to them, see what's up with their demons, and try to help them. But if you notice they're not trying to change and you see it's somewhat bringing you down, you gotta change your environment first. You gotta change your surroundings first if you want shit to happen. It's like trying to water a dead flower. Like, just stop. More flowers to come. Think about it. If your friend really does love you, they'll want to see you get to the top, even if it means before them. Man, I make sure I have my real ones. Emily, Wendy, what's up, girl? Those people that are honest with you, that want to see you go far, because there's not that many people around that want that for you. My mom even told me that. She was like, you're really only guaranteed like two like true best friends in your life, and look at. Yes, if you like this video or if you're going through this, please, I want to hear some of your stories, because I feel like I'm not the only one that dealt with this. I cannot be the only one that dealt with this. So I want to definitely hear it. Like, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff in the goodie bags. Bye.